So it got us thinking, 3,000 strikeouts, right? You wonder, with the way starting pitchers are used today, how many times we're going to see it going forward. CC Sabathia is right there. You see Verlander and Scherzer are within range. But I'm curious what you guys think and how many more times we will actually see this. And Clayton Kershaw is an interesting one in his own right, right? He's a relatively far distance away. And really, the only thing is his health. If he's healthy, I think he's going to get there. But Train, if you're making a guess there on Kershaw and who else is going to join that club?
I think maybe even Kershaw. And the only reason why I say maybe is because of his health, especially the last couple of years. It's been tough for him to even get managed 25 starts. And it's not only your stuff, but the consistency to go out there is key. So, and the game is played different now. We're seeing a lot more power arms come out of the bullpen. They want to give the hitters different looks of power. So it's tough for the starting pitcher to stay in the game longer and have more of an outcome, not only in the ball game, but in the strikeout department as well. Only 13 guys threw 200 innings last year. In 2005, my best year, there was 50 guys in the league that threw 200 plus innings. So you can see the game is going to a different aspect. So it's going to be tough, man. I don't know. Kershaw might come up a little short. EK, you're the Dodger insider over here. But we'll see. After him, I'm not sure anybody else is going to touch it again.
Yeah, no, I'm looking at Kershaw, and that's kind of the over-under line right there.
Right.
And I just, again, you hit it right on the head. It's just a health concern. Those other guys, I just don't think they've got a shot, whether it's health issues with Sale and Strasburg. Cole just feels like he's too far away. Bauer throws a ton of innings. You know, how is he going to keep that up? A ton of pitches.
Yeah.
Strasburg gets hurt.
Right. You know, I just don't. You know, and the Kershaw thing is interesting. And, you know, we'll be able to tell a lot after this year. You know, how does he navigate himself through this year? Remember, he started with the shoulder injury in spring training. You know, now he's had two starts. You know, very nice two starts. Not, you know, Clayton Kershaw of old, but still one of the better pitchers, better outings. But I don't think he's the strikeout guy. He's the last of the group here, I think.
Yeah,
let me throw one random possibility. Not random. Guy's a great pitcher. But Madison Bumgarner, he's 29. He's got 1,600. So he's more than halfway there. He's a horse. He could potentially play for a long time. Maybe?
The only thing about him is now they're starting to have starts like Clayton Kershaw where they only strike out six people, five people. So now you're definitely going to have to stay off the DL and make 25 to 30 starts a season. And you have to stay in the National League, too, because now you have that pitcher in there to get some quality strikeouts. But if they go to the American League and leave a ball club and go to the American League, it's going to be tough to obtain that, I think.
And you remember Dwight Gooden. We go back to the mid-'80s, you know, Dr. K. And this was a guy that was electric and just strikeout guy after guy with the New York Mets. But later on, he learned how to pitch. And that's the sort of thing where, look, I'd rather get a guy out on two or three pitches than strike somebody out having to throw four or five.
Absolutely.
And that's where, you know, the Kershaw, the Bumgarner, they'll definitely sacrifice the ego thing for the win and the longevity, because both of those guys are absolute competitors and they're cerebral. And they know what they're going to have to do if they want to continue to be at the elite level.
It's fascinating. I mean, CC Sabathia should get their next couple starts, and then who knows? Maybe we won't see it ever again in the game.